Good evening. It's 9:45, just gone. Yeah, 9:47 exactly, according to my computer. Just got in the door from Mum's. Had a lovely roast dinner. Lovely roast chicken, as I do most Sundays, anyway. Yeah, I've literally just got in the door. I got roped into fixing her clothes dryer. Because it wasn't broken, it worked, but when it got up to temperature, or got really hot, the damn thing would squeak like hell. And it was an ear-piercing squeak. And I had a look yesterday, but couldn't pinpoint where the squeak was. So when I went over today, we lifted it down from its shelf, because it's in a shelf in the porch, and took it outside, because the tumble dryer's not heavy, so we took it outside, so I had lots of room to work on it. And I took the lid off, because you've got to take the lid off to take the back cover off. And after I'd done that, I took off the covers for the motor. There's like a fan on the back of the motor. It's in the main shaft. But behind this fan is where the belt goes to drive it. And it also goes through, two tensioner pulleys, I think would be the proper name for them. I'm not an expert with tumble dryers. I just like fixing things. And there's also two, like, rubber wheels bolted to the back that the drum itself rolled against. They're like little support wheels, I suppose. So just to make sure I got the squeak, as I didn't know where it was, I dropped a bit of oil on pretty much every moving part there was in the back there. And threw it all back together. And the best thing was, I've managed to throw it all together without having any screws over and without missing any screws. And that's usually Sod's Law, that when you do things like that, you'll end up with either a screw left over or a screw missing. But I managed to do it with no screws missing. But it hadn't squeaked at all after I'd done that, so wherever the squeak was, I obviously got it. And it was like a dry squeak, like there was a dry bearing or something in the back there. I couldn't feel that any bearings anywhere had gone. I mean, the actual motor shaft was good and sturdy. There was no playing that. There was no playing any of the pulley wheels. So I think perhaps as it heats up, it probably just dried something out. So I just dropped a bit of oil on everything and it's working a treat now. That's pleased Mum, because she hasn't got to keep turning it off to let the tumble dryer cool. To turn it on again about 20 minutes later after it's cooled, just to let it heat up again and start that horrible squeaking sound for her to turn it off. It's taken her a lot longer to dry the clothes that way. So, and it was driving everyone up the wall, so it's been doing it on and off for weeks, and it only did it when it got really, really hot. So that's fixed for her. I don't actually know how I fix things. People say I'm good at it, but I'm not an expert. You know, I'll take something apart to look at to see if I can fix it. And of course, I'm not one of these people that'll just go into it like a bull in a china shop and just pull it apart and then think, I don't know how to put it back together now. Or they don't take it apart properly. When I do it, I'll look at what I've got in front of me and I can't think of the word now. Basically, just look the whole thing over and see how it comes apart. And once I've ascertained how it comes apart, I'll then take it apart. I don't just think, alright, I'll just pull it off any old how. and end up breaking something. You know, methodically, I think that's... would that be the right word? I'd go into it with a method. Something like that. Anywho, I'm now out of things to fix. I don't think there's anything left at Mum's to fix now. That's been driving everyone up the wall over there for weeks. I just thought it was about time someone did something about it. And I think my stepdad would have normally, but with his condition at the minute, he hasn't really had the energy or the strength to do anything like that. Well, he has, but he gets tired quite easily since his accident, so I don't mind doing things like that. It gives me something to do while I'm over there. I just thought I'd turn the camera on and do a short vlog. I don't mind doing these vlogs. Not that I actually do anything of interest. Well, some people might find it interesting. I don't find it interesting. But, I don't want to, you know, drag out a vlog too long. I know there's some vloggers I watch on YouTube that can go into like 20 minutes to half an hour or so, but that's probably about the average of mine on a normal video. But unless I completely ramble about a load of bollocks, which is what I normally do, then I don't think I'll be able to knock out long videos. And in my experience of loitering on YouTube, it seems a lot of people prefer shorter videos. Unless, of course, you are doing a tutorial where you've got to go into something in detail. But I don't mind. You know, if I get bored of a video, I'll just stop it. I don't complain about it. No, I watch YouTubers that can knock out videos up to an hour long or more, and sometimes I will watch the whole video, but if I get bored or need to go do something else, I'll either pause the video or just stop the video. I don't see why people have got to go into the comments and complain. I don't like your long videos, make them shorter. And if you don't like the long videos, don't watch them. No one's forcing you to sit at your computer or sit with your mobile phone device or tablet or whatever and forcing you to watch the video in full. It's the same as people that watch videos that don't appeal to them. You know, it's something they're not interested in. There's YouTubers I'm subscribed to that will put out a video every now and again that, you know, isn't my cup of tea, but I just choose not to watch it. I don't watch it and then complain in the comments section. I don't see the point in doing that, you know. If it's not your cup of tea, then don't watch it. You can usually tell from either the thumbnail they use, because some YouTubers know how to edit like that and put their own custom thumbnails in. Thumbnails. And the title. A lot of YouTubers I watch are really good at putting up a good title, so I can usually I'll decide looking at the title. You know, I don't understand why people feel the need to complain about everything in the comments. If you don't want to watch something, or it doesn't appeal to you, or it's not your cup of tea, or whatever, then just don't watch it. It's the same with trolling. I don't understand why people, or what sort of kick people get out of trolling people. Yeah, I've done a teeny bit of trolling in my time, but it's usually trolling other trolls. You know, just giving as good as they're giving. And give them as good as they're giving whoever they're trolling. Or if they've said something completely stupid, then I might troll them. But I've never trolled any video uploader. Nope. Well, I need to go use the bathroom, so I'm going to end the video here and... Whoops, nearly tripped over. And I think of anything else to talk about, I'll turn the camera on. No doubt I will, so hopefully I'll be back. Hey, I'm back. Oh, I completely forgot what I was going to talk about now. I did think of something. Never mind. I suppose I could talk about plans for tomorrow. Not that I have a lot. I've got a kid's bike that needs to be broken for any salvageable parts, which will take me all of 10 minutes to do, because there isn't really a lot on it I need or want. Brake pads maybe, saddle maybe, and possibly the tires, because they'll fit my little bike trailer. So they'll do a spares for that. Yeah, can't think of anything else that I'd want off of it. Just take a few bits off and I'll put the rest on the scrap trailer. I've got a bit of a quiet week ahead. Well, as I said in previous video, I've got another laptop, another compact LTE Elite laptop coming. I can't do anything with that until it gets here. Oh, pardon me. A bit of gas from drinking Coke all day. Well, I suppose I could clean that mess up. It all needs to be sorted out and rearranged and what have you. Ooh, that's what I've got to do. Got to check my stuff on eBay. And actually, the boss of the group, SyAdmin, he has messaged me. I don't know if there's a problem or not. Let's just have a look through my 49 notifications and... Oh, he's messaging me. Yep. No. Today. Oh, hello. This is one I... Admin in the classic car graveyard. What? Click on Shane Moore. Go back. There we go. Yeah, 10 requests to join to go through. I might as well show you what I do to check. Daryl Kelly joined Facebook more than a year ago, member of two groups. That's the sort of thing I'll read and automatically approve. Now you see with this one, Sundowner Transport joined Facebook more than a month ago, member of 67 groups. Now from that I can tell that all he's doing to join a group is probably to advertise a business. I could almost guarantee if I approve it, that's what I'm going to find for pending posts, because we have our posts set to where us admins have to approve them, and I've got 12 to look at. So I'm going to choose to ignore him. The next one joined more than a year ago. Same again, same again, same again. I've got 4 more to go. Same again, same again. Same again. Same again. Oh, for some reason he's already a member of the group, but he's still showing up in here. And that's a Facebook glitch. Well, there's a reason I've just tipped the camera up, and I do apologise if you got a quick glimpse of that. But it is pornographic. Well, you can't actually see anything, but you get the gist of what's going on, and I know that's probably a hacked account, but that has to be banned, so I'm not risking the group like that. But typically that's the first one at the top here. Yep, that's a pass. Now you see, this is an advert of a car for sale, but I can't approve it because it's not got everything Bossman requires for an advert. Mostly, it doesn't have a location, it doesn't have a price either. So that gets deleted, as per my boss's rules. Yeah, I can approve that one, and that one. That was an Edsel. Ooh. I'm not sure what that is. That look a bit like a Chevy badge on the back of that. That's nice. That would be worth saving. No, not delete. Approve. That looks remarkably like a Ford Thunderbird, that one. I'm not very familiar with my classic American. I don't know, that look a bit long for Ford on the hood letters there. I'll approve it and we'll go back and have a look. Ooh, that's a big wagon. For sale, located in Idaho. $550. See, you Americans, you say OBO, or best offer. Over here in the UK, it's ONO, or near offer. Basically the same thing, just a different way of saying it. But, just thought I'd mention that as it came up there. So, yep, we can approve that. Here's another one. See, comic one. That's a ban. Bye. Oh my god, giant pythons appeared in Texas. Well, I know damn well that's how these pornographic stuff gets into your account, because people will click on something like this, thinking it's a genuine video, and it isn't. I'm not going to... Well, here we go. If I click on it like that, this is what happens. Right? You get a blank page. See, it's a video that doesn't exist. That's why I don't click on videos like that. Because if it sounds obscene like that when you look at the picture and read the title, then it most likely is something that doesn't exist and is obscene. So don't fall for them, please. Okay, what am I going to do? What were we going to do? Oh yeah, that was it. Scroll down, where is it? The one I thought was a T-Bird. Is that a T-Bird? It's got an M on the front there. I can't quite make out the letters. I think the last letter up the end here, well, is a Y. Mercury. Dumbass. Yeah, I can see it now. It's a Mercury. Should have been obvious from the M on the front there, really. Never mind. Ah, it looks so much like a T-Bird. Oh, no it doesn't. I have seen one difference. There's that little bit up there. I'm not sure if that's a light or a vent or... What's this one then? That looked like that might be a Dodge badge on the front there. But again, I don't know my old cars. Well, that's got no parts off written in the window, so I assume they'd want to sell that as a whole car. It does actually look complete though. At least from this angle, you know, there's no lights missing from the front, which you often see. All the chrome trim seems to be present. And that one beside it there has got no parts off written on it as well. Hopefully they'll get sold as complete vehicles. Does it come with the Do the weeds come free with it? Edsel, you can't mistake an Edsel grill. Can't see nothing in that one either. Nope, there's no motor in that one. Someone had that. He's just one of my favourite groups to admin. Rusty old transporter truck with rusty old cars on it. Lovely jubbly. Anyway, let's get on to what I was going to do as well. Well, my battery and card are still hanging in there. Right, got my eBay. Yeah, I'm watching these floppy disks. They're Windows 95 floppy disks. Because he's asking £10 for them, which I am prepared to pay. I'm not sure if that's overpriced or not. I don't know what stuff like that is worth, but as I'm wanting to get that compact LTE working, I'm not sure if the laptop I've bought has got a working hard drive installed in it, let alone actually working, so I'm watching that just in case. Because it doesn't have a CD-ROM, so I can't use the CD-ROM version of it. Has anything, I can't remember if anything's ending today. Ooh, got some more feedback left for me. 2 items end today. No, they all end tomorrow. I've only got 1 item with a bid on it. Boo! Come on. That Mavic rear wheel should sell. I've got another frame I can dig up from the shed tomorrow. That can go on. So who left me feedback? No, I know the Ferrari did. Ah! That's for the bike. And he left positive. Yay! Just what I like to read. Good, thanks. I could have put a bit more detail than that. Oh well. Can't complain, it's positive. Oh good, they paid for that. Took them long enough. So I am still waiting for a payment to come through. It's Sunday the 26th, just in case you're wondering what day I'm filming this on. Complete randomness. Bill's Team Max is playing GTA Sunday. Online multiplayer racing. On a lawnmower. Okay. One Lonely Farmer. Jim Lindenis. Battery going. Battery failing. Sorry, I've got a pair down there to put back in it. But I've probably almost ran out of card space anyway. I've got a few minutes on here, actually. I don't know, about 15 minutes. The batteries ain't going to last 15 minutes. But like I said, this is just a random sort of video log, just like yesterday's. I think on that note, as my battery's sort of flashing between amber and red, I don't know what does that. I suppose it's just how the battery warning image works on this. Now it's gone to red. No, amber again. No, red. Now amber. Oh well. Stupid little camera, but it does it. Does what I need it to do for now. You know, it doesn't pick up anything clearly on the monitor, but which is a bit of a drag because it means I've literally got to describe what I'm pointing the camera at, and read everything out. I can't just hover the camera. And honestly, it doesn't even focus at all. So yeah, one day in the near future. Ah, I wonder if Mum would be interested in going to a car boot next weekend, weather permitting. So I've heard it's supposed to be really bad during the week. Hello, Nemo. Anyway, I'm going to end the camera. Well, I could end the camera, but I wouldn't be able to make any more videos if I did. I'm going to end the video. And thank you for watching, if you survived the video. But, the way I see it, something's better than nothing. So, yep, I'm going to shut the video down. And if I think of anything else, or do anything interesting tonight, then I'll pick the camera up. As usual, but until next time, I'll talk to you again soon, so...